As India is preparing for a likely third wave of COVID-19 soon, much focus has been emphasized on improving pediatric patient care both in the hospital as well as home. I am Hepzibah Joseph, working as an assistant professor in College of Nursing AIIMS, Bhubaneswar, would like to present how to provide parental support for pediatric patients with COVID-19 in the hospital. The objective of my session is, at the end of this session, the participants able to understand on parental measures supposed to be provided for COVID-19 children admitted in the hospital from admission to discharge and apply those parental supportive measures with positive attitude while caring COVID-19 children in community and hospital. In the next 10 to 15 minutes, we are going to discuss about how to carry out admission procedure for a child with COVID-19 and what are the classification for COVID illness in children, how to provide parental support in place of casualty, suspected ward, COVID unit as well as in COVID ICU, how to transfer a child from non-COVID unit to the COVID unit or COVID ICU, and at the end we'll discuss about discharge or post-COVID care to be provided at home for the children. Now let us see how a COVID-19 child may approach to a healthcare facility. A child who confirmed with COVID-19 or suspected a probable case of COVID-19 may brought to the healthcare facility in an ambulance or by walk with the help of their parents. And in the emergency department, the child will be registered and the child has to undergo a thorough assessment. The assessment include history collection, physical examination and saturation monitoring and other necessary assessment in the body system. After the complete assessment in the emergency department, the child who is already confirmed with COVID-19 outside can be directly admitted to the COVID unit or the COVID ICU, and the treatment can be initiated for that particular child. On the other hand, a child who is suspected or probable case of COVID-19 can be admitted in the COVID suspected ward until the result out for that particular child. Now, let us see who are all the children considered as suspected case. There are three criteria. Out of these three, if a child fit into any one criteria, can be considered as suspected case. Number one, the child who is having acute respiratory illness, presenting with cough, shortness of breath, having history of travel to or residing in a location reported as community transmission of COVID-19 during the last 14 days prior to the onset of symptom. And number two, a child having acute respiratory illness with shortness of breath and cough and having contact with a patient who is COVID-19. And the third criteria is severe respiratory illness, having fever and at least one symptom of respiratory disease like cough, shortness of breath and require hospital admission. And out of these three, if any one criteria of the child fits, the child can be considered as suspected case. On the other hand, who is considered as probable case? A child who has given RT-PCR test and the COVID result, if it is inconclusive, the child can be considered as probable case to COVID-19. Now, when the result is out, if the child turned to COVID positive, the child can be treated according to the disease classification of COVID-19 and the child can be home isolated or the child can be shifted to COVID ward or COVID ICU. If the child is COVID negative, the child can be treated for the illness in the non-COVID suspected ward. Now let us discuss about COVID illness classification in children. There are four different classifications. The first classification is asymptomatic COVID positive child. In the family, any one member may be identified as COVID-19 and this particular child also present with COVID-19 result without any signs and symptoms. So what to do for such children? There is no requirement of any investigation nor treatment but home isolation and observation of symptom is highly essential. So what to monitor, how to monitor, and when to report to the healthcare facility for a child presented with asymptomatic COVID positive will be discussed by one of our team member. The second classification of COVID illness in children is mild illness. In mild illness, the child will present with sore throat, rhinorrhea, cough without any breathing difficulty or GI symptoms. In this mild illness, there is no requirement of hospital admission or investigation. The child can be under home isolation, monitoring, as well as symptomatic treatment. The third classification of COVID illness in children is moderate illness. In moderate illness, the child may present with cough, sore throat, rhinorrhea, breathing difficulty, oxygen saturation more than 90% with increased respiratory rate. For these children, if according to the clinical condition, investigation can be done as required and inpatient treatment has to be initiated. The fourth classification of COVID illness in children is severe illness. In severe illness, the child may present with oxygen saturation less than 90%, grunting, severe chest retraction, lethargy, and seizure. In this situation, the child may require ICU admission and intensive care treatment. The next important topic we are going to discuss is parental support. What are the parental supports supposed to be provided to the child in the emergency as well as suspected ward? The first and foremost support is parental presence. Parental presence is highly essential from the time of admission to the time of discharge and throughout the hospital stay. It will help the child to cooperate in a better way for all the nursing care procedures, as well as it will psychologically support the child too. So never ever restrict parental presence throughout the hospital stay for the child. And the next parental support is explaining hospital policy to the parents as well as older children. So explaining the hospital policy helps the parents to aware about hospital environment and other procedures like admission, investigation, treatment, and so on. So a proper orientation to the parents and explaining the hospital policy will help to reduce the anxiety too. And the next support is explaining on COVID appropriate behavior. It is the responsibility of the healthcare professional to encourage the parents as well as the child to follow COVID appropriate behavior in the hospital. If a child or the parents are there without any mask or any minimal PPE, personal protective equipments, the healthcare provider can give a mask to the parent and explaining in detail about COVID appropriate behavior, including cough fatigue, mask fatigue, and maintaining social distancing throughout the hospital stay. The next parental support is clarifying the doubt and reassuring the parents. The health team members who are available in the emergency department as well as in the suspected ward should be approachable, and they should respect and understand the parental concern. They should ready to listen to the parents and responding in a simplified manner in parents' own language. Reassuring the parents will help to restore their confidence as well as reducing their worry or uncertainty about the child's condition. In addition with these support, holistic care also should be provided to the child. The child is now not confirmed COVID-19, waiting for the result in the suspected ward. Even then, in this state, the child's physical needs like respiratory needs, nutritional needs, hygienic needs, and psychological needs also should be met in the COVID suspected unit. And now, the child who is already confirmed COVID positive, they will be shifted from the emergency department to the COVID units as we discussed before. Now, the child who is waiting for 24 to 48 hours for the COVID result, and the result, once the result is out, and if it is COVID positive, according to the COVID-19 disease illness classification for children, if the child falls into moderate or severe category, the child will be shifted to COVID unit or COVID ICU. On the other hand, if the child falls into mild or asymptomatic COVID positive category, the parents will be instructed on home isolation measures, including monitoring danger signs like breathing difficulty, shortness of breath, and instruction on symptomatic treatment to be continued for the child. Now let us see how to transfer a child from non-COVID unit to COVID unit or COVID ICU. In the pediatric units like pediatric surgery, pediatric medicine, pediatric intensive care unit as well as NICU, the child who is taking treatment for any other system illness presenting with COVID symptoms like fever, sore throat, rhinorrhea, cough, breathing difficulty and GA symptoms associated with COVID-19 has to be isolated immediately from the ward, and the child should give COVID sampling. Once the child gives the COVID sampling, within 24 to 48 hours, the result will be out. In the result, if the child found positive, the child can be classified according to COVID-19 disease severity illness in children. If the child falls into the classification of moderate or severe, the child will be shifted to the COVID ward or COVID ICU. And suppose the child having asymptomatic illness or maybe mild illness, the child will be advised for home isolation, and parents has to be explained about monitoring and other symptomatic treatment to be followed at home. On the other hand, if the child is turned COVID negative, the child can continue their treatment in the non-COVID pediatric unit itself. Now let us see, in a family, if the parent or the child who turned positive, how to care about. In case if the mother and the newborn had turned COVID positive, the mother and the newborn can be stayed together. The mother can continue giving breastfeeding as far as possible. And if the mother is positive but the child is negative, and you are sure that no one in the family is available to take care of the child, the mother and the child can be together in the hospital. At the same time, mother should follow COVID appropriate behavior throughout hospitalization. Suppose if the child is positive but the parents are negative. In such situation, parents with possible minimal PPE and following COVID appropriate behavior, they can take care of the child in the hospital. And all the child who is above 2 years of old, they should wear mask and never allow grandparents to take care of the child in the hospital or at home in case if the child is COVID positive. Coming to the parent support in the COVID unit, the COVID unit may be an unpleasant experience for the child as well as the parents. The main reason is the healthcare workers with PPE, starting from sanitary worker to the physician. It's a great challenge for them, healthcare workers, to communicate with the parents as well as the child. And not only communication, it will affect the socialization with the child too. But this should not be a reason for restricting the communication with the parents as well as the child. The first and foremost support can be provided was ward orientation. The parents have to be oriented to the ward, the nurse's station, washroom, pantry room, and other facilities available in the ward. And another important thing to be kept in the mind is permitting one parent throughout the hospital stay. It is always encourageable to make any one parent or the caregiver to be with the child throughout the hospital stay to prevent further infection. So restrict the parents to moving out of the COVID unit all the time. And followed by that, connecting with the family members should be encouraged by the healthcare workers. So the child can be connected with the family members, relatives, friends with the help of video chat or any other mode of communication, so that they may not be feeling stress, loneliness in the COVID stay. Few strategies to enhance parental support during the stay in the COVID unit are listening to their parents and available to them all the time throughout the hospital stay, and time to time updating on health condition of the child and clarifying their doubts, whether it is small or big, whenever it is asked to the parents, and timely explanation and in an understanding way without using any medical terminologies, and in their own language if it is clarified, that will be a great support for their parents during the hospital stay. In addition to communication support, it is also essential to assist the parents in meeting the physical needs, psychological needs of the child throughout the hospital stay, and encouraging the parents to involve in child care during the hospital stay in the COVID unit really helps the parents to feel that they have given care for the child in times of illness, as well as it will promote the family-centered care, and parents also will have a good satisfaction towards the child care in the COVID unit, and providing family support as well in terms of psychologically and spiritually will bring them hope towards child's progress, and this will give definitely this will change the hospital environment for the child as well as the parents in the COVID unit. In addition to parental support, it is also essential to provide physical support for the child. Physical support in terms of meeting their respiratory needs. Suppose in case if the child require any oxygen, connecting the child to the oxygen source through oxygen mask or oxygen hood, nasal catheter, nasal prongs, or rebreathing mask, CPAP, or if the child is in the COVID ICU, connecting the child to the mechanical ventilator is essential. And next to that, maintaining hydration of the child. So in case if the child is on NPO, initiating the IV lines, starting the IV fluid, and maintaining the intake output chart. And if the child is not on NPO, ensuring that the child get adequate fluid, intake of adequate fluid every day. It's highly essential that the child will not go into dehydration status, and meeting the nutritional needs either through oral diet or NG feed will really help the child for the speedy recovery from this COVID infection. We have come to the end of today's presentation on parental support for child with COVID-19. Parental support will help to alleviate fear, promote comfort to the parents as well as the child, and enhance the faith and confidence of the parents in speedy recovery of the child with COVID-19. It is the responsibility of the health team members to provide parental support to any child admitted with COVID-19 throughout the hospital stay. Not only that, parental support will promote the health of the child in all the dimensions, including physical, psychological, spiritual, and social health of the child. Parental support acts as a route or channel for family-centered care, and together we can win the COVID war along with parental support. And thank you all for your patient listening on parental support for COVID-19. Once again, thank you.